Нет, я заряд слышал вас отлично. Продолжайте полет.
Полет продолжается хорошо. Перегрузки растут. Медленно, незначительно. Все переносится хорошо. Эмоции небольшие. Самочувствие отличное. В иллюминатор зона наблюдаю. Земля все больше закрывается облаками. Прием.
It was always something of a disappointment that Yuri Gagarin never really came back with any good film footage of what he saw from space on that first flight around the Earth. So at the beginning of 2010, when a new window was put onto the International Space Station, I suddenly thought, I wonder if we can film a new view of what Gagarin first saw 50 years before. So I emailed the European Space Agency, because I've worked with them in the past, and asked them, first of all, if they thought it might even just be possible to do it. Could we match the orbit of the International Space Station to Gagarin's original ground path? Needed to do was film at exactly the same time of day that Gagarin had flown. So he launched just after 6 o'clock in the morning, Greenwich Mean Time, flew into the night side of the Earth over the Pacific, down through the night, through across the Pacific Ocean in the dark, out into the dawn light over the South Atlantic, just south of Argentina, and then up across Africa in the morning light and home. And we had to cover that ground at exactly the same time of day. And when we did the maths on that, we realized that only happened about every 6 weeks or so. So then, when we got those plans in order, it was over to Paolo Nespoli on board the space station.
We are here near the cupola. Let's see if we can see anything. I will take you and drag you with me.
I heard for the first time of the First Orbit Film project while I was in training in Star City. At the beginning I thought it was a little bit of a bizarre idea, but the more I thought about it, the more I thought it would be interesting. It would be interesting to see what Yuri Gagarin saw. Filming in space has all sort of challenging, even more than filming on Earth, thanks to the float around, it's microgravity. We had a challenge because you know, our day here is very busy. We do experiments, we maintain the station, we do research. So we had to really find a way and kind of fight to find the time to film this one. But this was such, or became such an important and interesting project that we did find time, and we made sure that we allocated enough resources to make this a success.
When we got the footage into the cutting room in early 2011, it became quite apparent that we needed a good musical score to carry the film. So I sent a rather cheeky email to the composer Philip Shepherd, who we collaborated with on In the Shadow of the Moon a few years before. And to be perfectly honest, I didn't really expect to get a reply. I mean, when you ask a composer for 90 minutes of new music and then you mention you haven't got a budget, they're not likely to get back to you. But Philip did reply very generously, and it turned out he'd been working on an album called Cloud Song, which was actually inspired by spaceflight. And even more coincidentally, there was a copy of this album already up on the space station. It turned out that he was friends of the husband of another astronaut called Kathy Coleman. And Catherine had taken his music onto the space station along with Paolo Nespoli. They flew up together in November 2010. And so at one end of the space station, Caddy Coleman was listening to Philip's music for First Orbit, and at the other end of the space station, Paolo Nespoli was filming for First Orbit, and they didn't know about this connection. And so I managed to get a message up to them, and they got to talk about it.
Объект вращается, очевидно, работает солнечная система иллюминатора.
Another important part of First Orbit was to try and unite these new pictures that we got with Gagarin's original mission audio that was recorded both on board the spacecraft and on the radio downlinks back to Earth. And we searched everywhere for this recording. We got Roscosmos, the Russian Space Agency, involved. We got the British Council, the British Embassy, NATO. We even got the Russian military involved at one point. And eventually, with just a few days to go, we managed to track it down at the Russian State Archive, and we got it into the edit with literally just hours to go, then worked through the weekend, through the nights, to reunite this audio with the new pictures. And I'm delighted that we've got it in. It's the first time that this mission audio, this historic recording, has been heard in its entirety outside of Russia. And what better place to hear it than against these new pictures of what Gagarin was also seeing as he was speaking 50 years ago.
Петр, я заря один, все в порядке, машина идет хорошо, прием. Понял вас, вижу, реки, складки местности. Различим хорошо, видимость хорошая, отлично все вам тоже видно, прием.
On April 12th, when the rest of the world will be watching the movie, we'll be here on the space station celebrating Yuri Gagarin's legacy. I'm not sure we will be able to watch the film, but for sure we will go at the window and look outside again and enjoy our beautiful Earth. This will be our way to celebrate Yuri Gagarin, celebrate the first human in space, and celebrate us as a human kind that expands our knowledge, capability, and know-how outside of the Earth. This is where we need to go. This is our future.